Dilemma of God. My name is Mohammad Tambari, PhD candidate of Geography and Urban Planning Fellows, University of Mashhad, and as a visiting scholar at UDelft. The subject I'm going to speak is about the livable city, and the title of my thesis is Analysis of Livable Indicators in Metropolis of Mashhad, Iran. By 2050, 70% of global population will reside within cities. Considering the increase of the urban population in the world, different strategies have been adopted to improve the living condition in cities. One of these strategies is CDS, or City Development Strategy. City Development Strategy, as an emerging strategic urban planning approach to maintain sustainability, and CDS try to improve local economics and reduce urban poverty while also contributing towards relationship between sustainable urbanization goals and local objectives and priorities. There are four principles of CDS, and including competitiveness, bankability, and good governance and management, and finally, livability. In this presentation, I want to speak about the livability. We all have different reasons to live in a city. Some cities appear comfortable to live in, some are challenging, some are boring, some are dangerous. In this presentation, I have two main questions and I want to speak about them. Firstly is, what is livable city? And another question is, what is the criteria of livability? Livability as an umbrella that covers different meaning. And up to now, several definitions have been proposed for livability, and this difference in definition seems normal because livability in different fields are used, such as urbanism, environment, geography, sociology, architecture, and urban planning, and etc. Over the last decade, livability has become a popular term used in the world, and the simplest definition about the livable city is a city can provide the best living condition for now and future. Another definition about livable city is one where people like to and can afford to live. We spoke about what is livable city, and another and next slide I want to speak about what are the criteria of livability. Several studies have been done about the criteria of urban livability in international institutions and academic centers, which in this presentation will mention two of the most important ones. Firstly, I want to speak about the Economics Intelligence Unit, or EIU. The Economics Intelligence Unit, as an independent business within the Economics Group, providing forecasting and advisory services through research and analysis. The Economics Intelligence Unit also produces regular reports on livability and cost of living of the world's major cities that receive wide coverage in international media. Based on the study of the Economics Intelligence Unit, there are about six criteria. And these criteria including stability, healthcare, culture, environment, education, and infrastructure. These criteria including over than 30 sub-criteria. The another reference about the criteria of livability is Melbourne University. In the Place Health and Livability Research Program, after survey of over 100 reference which was related to livability, present 11 criteria about livable city. Based on the study of this academic center, these criteria including crime and security, housing, education, employment and income, health and social services, transport, public open space, social cohesion, and local democracy, gender and culture, food and other local goods, and natural environment. And these criteria including over than 100 sub-criteria. This slide, I want to speak about the ranking of livable city on August of 2015. It's important, you know, there are a lot of cities in the world, and this ranking, and it is based on the study of economics intelligence, just including 140 cities in the world. Absolutely, there are a lot of cities in the world can put in this ranking. And the rank one is for Melbourne, Australia. Was ranked by the EIU as the world's most livable city since 2011 among the 2014 cities survived. And the population of this city is 4.4 million people. Rank is for Vienna, Australia. The capital and the largest city of Austria with population about 1.8 million persons in 2014. Ranked 3 is for Vancouver, Canada. Vancouver is one of the most ethnically and linguistically diverse cities in Canada and as a better global city in the world. The rank 4 is for Toronto, Canada. Toronto is the largest city by population among the top 10 livable cities with nearly 6 million inhabitants within its metropolitan area. And the rank 5 is for the another city of Australia, Adelaide. The population of Adelaide is 1.3 million and it has been noted for early example of religious freedom, commitment to political progressives and civil liberties. It has been known as the city of church since the mid-19th century. And the rank of 6 is for Calgary, Canada. Calgary is recognized as a Canadian leader in the oil and gas industry as well as for being a leader in economic expansion. And rank 7 is for Sydney, Australia. Sydney is the most populous city in Australia by 4.8 million people. The Sydney area has been inhabited by indigenous Australians for 10 of millennia. And the rank of 8 is for another city of Australia, the Perth. This city have a population about 2 million persons. And the rank 9 is for Auckland in New Zealand. Auckland is the largest and the most populous urban area in New Zealand. And Auckland has a population of 1.4 million people, which constitute 31% of country population in 2014. This map, we can see the location of New Zealand and is located east of Australia. And is this map, we can see the position of Auckland and is located the north of New Zealand. The final rank in the top 10 ranking is for Helsinki, Finland. Helsinki region has a 26% of total population of Finland. The Helsinki metropolitan area generates approximately one-third of Finland GDP or gross domestic product. And this map, we can see the position of Helsinki in the Finland and is located the south of Finland. From the top 10 livable cities in the world, there are 4 cities in Australia and there are 3 cities in Canada. Top rank for this city are due to having the perfect condition of security, economic, healthcare, and infrastructure, environment, and culture. And this slide, I want to speak about the 5 livable city in this ranking among the 140 cities in the world. The rank of 136 is for Tripoli, Libya. In this map, we can see the position of Tripoli, and is located in the north of Africa. And this city have a lot of problem, and some of the problem and this city are including civil war, lack of security, destruction of urban infrastructure, shortage of clean drinking water. Another city is Lagos, Nigeria. The population of this city is about 21 million persons, and is located west of Africa and have a lot of problems like informal settlement, unsuitable housing, environment pollution, abandoned rubbish, and problem of public transportation, high density, and poverty. Another land is for Port Moresby in Papua New Guinea, or PNG, and is located north of Australia, and is there a lot of problem like high poverty, low security, and insurgent militants. The rank of 139 is for Dhaka, Bangladesh. This city, like another city, have a lot of problems, including natural hazards, especially torrential rains, widespread poverty, problem of occupation, and low level of public health. And final rank is for Damascus, Syria. I think you know the Damascus in Syria engaged from 2011 to war. Unfortunately, this problem made a lot of problems like insecurity, low level of public health, destruction of urban infrastructure, and short of clean drinking water. And this slide, we can see the changing of the score of livability in this city from 2010 to 2015 in the world. In this section, we can see the city have an increasing in these years, and the range of a score of 90 to 100, the city of Zurich, Honolulu in United States of America, and Adelaide increasing, and the highest number of increasing is for the range of 68 to 77. The highest changing and movement in this ranking is for Harare in Zimbabwe. After that is for the Kathmandu in Nepal, and the rank 3-4 is for Dubai in United States Emirates. In this section, we can see the city having any change in escort, not rank. In escort, this ranking, and the city of Melbourne, Washington DC, Lisbon, Singapore, New York, Rio de Janeiro, Rios, and Dhaka haven't any change in this ranking. This section, we can see the city have decreasing in this course. The rank of 90 to 100, the city of Vancouver and Vienna have decreased, and the highest number of changing is this range of 87 to 97. But this changing is low, not high. The highest changing is for Damascus. The Damascus decreasing about 26 scored in this course. After that, the Tripoli in Libya and Kiev. Kiev have increased about 25 score. After that, the Tripoli have about 22 scored in this course. The remarkable point about the majority of this city is this city, especially the city have rank under 70, engage in civil war and haven't security in this country. And the city of Athens, St. Petersburg, and Moscow have an economic problem in these years. And this map, we can see the position of the changing livability scores in the world. I think we don't need to explain this slide because I spoke about this subject in the last slide. Iran. Before I want to speak about Mashhad, I want to speak about Iran. Iran is located in the west of Asia and Middle East. It is a developing country with an oil economy, young people, high rate of urbanization, semi-arid climate, and strategic location. The capital of Iran is Tehran, and this slide we can see some picture of Iran. This slide we can see the population of Iran from 1956 to 2011. In 1956, the population of Iran was about 80 million people, and 2011, the population of Iran is about 75 million. This graph we can see the urban population of Iran and the population and the urban population of Iran in this year is about 53 million people. And this graph we can see compare the total population and urban population of Iran. This is the graph shows the rate of urbanization in Iran in these years, and it's so important from the 1956, Iran had 31% of urbanization, but in the 2011, the rate of urbanization changing to 71%. This graph we can compare the trend of urbanization change in Iran and the world from in these years, and yellow color is for the developed country, and light blue is for Iran, and this line is for world, and another line is for developing country. As you can see, the trend of urbanization in Iran same the developed country, and it showed the high urban population in Iran, and is upper than the developing country and the trend of in the world. This slide, I want to speak the numbers of cities in Iran, and this year, like 2011, there are about 1,331 cities in Iran. I think it's so high city in Iran, and the reason of this large number of cities in Iran is every place which have more than 10,000 people is now as a city in Iran. I think that every country have a lot of criteria about the city. And this graph, we can see population of city more than 1 million in Iran, and there are about 8 city have more than 1 million people, and the city of Tehran have about 8 million people in the world. This graph, we can compare the population of in 1 million persons in Iran compared to total population of Iran, and it constitutes 20% of total of population in Iran. This graph, we can compare the urban population by the population put in the city have more than 1 million, and it constitutes about 36% of total population of urban population. And Mashhad, the my study in my thesis. Mashhad is this is located in the northeast of Iran, and is map we can see the province of Iran. This picture we can see the image of Holy Shrine of Imam Reza. Every year, over 30 million pilgrims come Mashhad to visit Imam Reza Shrine. Mashhad is the city have a rapid growth. Mashhad is the second most populous city in Iran, with a rapid population growth and urban expansion in recent decades. This map, we can see the increasing in area of Mashhad in the 1956 to the 2011. In these years, the area of Mashhad increased over than 200 times in these years. And about the population, we can see in this year, the population of this metropolitan change and increasing about 100 times in these years. This is the map of the municipality zones of Mashhad, and there are 30 zones of in Mashhad. Based on a study have done in Iran, there are three categories of these zones, and they divide to three categories: developed zones, which are shown in the green color, and developing zones, which color of yellow, and finally the undeveloped zones by red color. It's important you know about near 1 million people is living in the informal settlement in Iran, in Mashhad, and is located the zones of 3, 4, 5, 6, and 7, and the section of the zone of 2. And unfortunately, this zone are in developing zone in Mashhad. Finally, the criteria of my thesis and my research is extracted from the place health and livability research, which prepared Melbourne University. I'm going to study 8 indicators of livability, which will be survived in Mashhad, Iran. This table, we can see the criteria and about the information, and I speak about the criteria of Melbourne University, the last slide. Finally, the main goal of my thesis is analyze the livability in different zones of Mashhad, and the research method of will be descriptive analytic, and GIS and SPSS software will be used in my thesis. And finally, I have some challenging in my thesis, and I want to know, let me know your opinion about this challenging to improve my work. The first my challenge is, how can I communicate between the criteria of livability, and another challenge is, how much is the weight of each criteria of livability in the world and in my science? Finally, watch two clips of Mashhad. One clip is for old Mashhad, another clip is for new Mashhad. This clip showed the position of Mashhad in the old, and this clip showed the position of Mashhad in the now. There are the two clips of Mashhad. I think it's interesting. Finally, thank you for your attention and your presence in my presentation. And I hope my presentation was good for you. Thank you very much.